also bring in Rajesh Palviya. He's the head of technical and derivative research at Access Security. It's great to have you with us, Rajesh. We've seen the markets see this downtrend over the last three odd sessions. How do you think the Nifty and the Bank Nifty are likely to do here on?
Yeah, good afternoon. If you look at the today's move of the market, you know, today is the again, you know, follow-up selling we have seen in the indices, and Nifty closed below 12,200 level, which is, you know, very negative for the near term trend, because if he continues to trade below 12,200 level, then we may see further more, you know, selling pressure in the near term basis. On the Nifty chart, if you look at the daily chart pattern, you know, on the 8th of January there was a bullish gap formation was there, and 12,130 is the, you know, upper band of that bullish gap. If he breaks below 12,130 level, then probable downside we can witness towards 12,050, which is the next important support area for the Nifty. Even if you look at on the derivative front also, you know, aggressive call writing was seen in the today's session on the 12,200 strike, which is, you know, again suggesting us that, you know, on the higher side 12,200, 12,250 is likely to act as a stiff resistance for any kind of, you know, minor pullback action in the near term basis. On the other hand, on the lower side, we have seen, you know, a lot of put writing was there at around 12,000 and 12,100 level. So broadly we can say, like, you know, 12,250 is the higher level for the Nifty in the near term, and on the lower side we are expecting that 12,100 to 12,050 could be the lower band for the Nifty for a few more trading session. On the Bank Nifty front, we are, you know, now trading below 31,000 level, which is, you know, again negative on the near term charts. And if you look at the chart pattern also, now Bank Nifty is trading below 50-day simple moving average, which is, you know, adding up the bearishness on the Bank Nifty front also. And looking at the data also, 31,000, you know, call writers are very aggressive at the current juncture, and the put writers now, you know, unwinding their position, which was there at around earlier it was around at 31,000 level, which is, you know, again showing up that, you know, we may see further more, you know, negativity in the Bank Nifty front, and lower side we can see a level of 30,750 on the lower side, which is the next important support area for the Bank Nifty. On the higher side, we are expecting that, you know, on the higher side 31,350, 31,400 is likely to act as a steep resistance for near-term pullback action.
All right, now we're waiting for the President of the United States, Donald Trump, to speak in Davos at the World Economic Forum. And perhaps as soon as he comes in and starts speaking, we'll cut across. But for the moment, let's answer some queries that have come in as well, Rajesh. This one is from our viewer, Ravi Raj, and he's sent us an email from Chennai. Ravi is asking, within the pharma pack, he's looking at two counters. There's Glenmark and there is Orchid Pharma. Orchid, like we know, huge spot of bother, but between these two counters, which one would you pick for him, if at all?
Yeah, if I want to choose from these two stocks only, then Glenmark would be my preferred bet, because, you know, if you look at the setup of Glenmark, it's consolidating in narrow range since last 1 month kind of time frame. And looking at the setup, I feel, you know, stock is in process to forming a base at current level. So my advice would be to buy Glenmark at the current level with stop loss of 330. And I'm expecting that once the stocks manages to cross about 365 level, then possible upside target we can witness towards 390, even 400 level on the higher side. But yes, looking at the both stock, I would suggest to buy Glenmark at the current level.
Another question is coming through the Twitter route. Our viewer Kalyana Krishnan has asked us about the 1,000 shares of Ashok Leyland that he purchased. He bought them at just under 98 rupees a share. So should he hold or sell this stock? This is important coming at a time that the auto sector, especially commercial vehicles, has seen so much pressure. The shift to BS6 has taken a good amount of investment from Ashok Leyland as well. So in that scenario, how does this particular counter, the counter of Ashok Leyland, look on the charts, Rajesh?
So Ashok Leyland is looking positive on the near term as well as on the short term chart. Also, stock is now trading above all its important moving average. Even if you look at the last 1 month, 2 month data, the stock managed to give breakout on the consolidation of, you know,
might have to interrupt you over there, because the President of the United States speaking in Davos at the World Economic Forum. Listen in.
His economic turnaround has been nothing short of spectacular. When I took office 3 years ago, America's economy was in a rather dismal.